I will assure you. He lived above the Reeland Bridge, that boy and his mother. Mm-hmm. He was 20 years of age. He took a notion about buying a fiddle. The mother told him that he never would learn. She says, you're too old, you're 20 years of age, she says, and you'll never learn to play the fiddle. Well, he says, I'm going to the town tomorrow, he says, and I'll buy a fiddle. Well, she says, carry on. Way he went to Belmafane, he bought a fiddle in it, and had the fiddle home with him, under his coat. So when he came in, he hung the fiddle upon a nail. You got a fiddle, she says, I did indeed, he says. Ah, she says, you were foolish. She, you'll never learn. Ah, well, he says, let her lie there, he says, someone will play it. But anyhow, they come a little boy in for him in the evening to go to play her a dancing at your hello. Oh, he says to the little boy, he says, I have no tunes. He says, I bought a fiddle, surely, he says, but I can't play. Oh, well, he says, come away in any case, he says, they'll be glad to see you in the fiddle. There'll be someone there, he says, to play the fiddle. So after a while, he took a notion he would just move off, and the young fellow went away ahead of him and on up to the dance house. And when he was going up at a very lonely place away up at a townland called Ballard, the wee red-haired man was out before him on the road, and him knocking about. Boys, he says, I wonder what kind of a wee man is this at this hour of the night. What was it but a fairy? And he didn't know it. Well, says the fairy, says he, boy, he says, are you going on a journey? I am, he says, surely, and I'm going on a journey. He says, I don't like to go. Where are you going? He says, I'm going to play at a dance. He says, and I have no tunes. I only have the fiddle, he says, 3 days. What kind have you with you? He says, oh, the fiddle's a new one, he says. Show me her, he says. So he catched, the fairy catched her, and he looked at her, and he done that 3 times across the fingerboard. Well, go you on now, he says, and there'll be no fiddle player like you there the night, he says. You'll be the best fiddle player, he says, in all Ireland. Oh, and he went, and when he went up, they all jumped to the floor. So he asked them what were they going to dance, and the poor fellow had no tunes. We're going to dance an Irish reel, this boy, he says. All right, he says, carry on. So he says, I'll play you an Irish reel. So this is the reel he played. That's the fairy reel.
Lovely.
The fairy reel.
Appropriate tune.
So, he remained the best fiddle player was in all Ireland, and he lived to be 85 years of age, and he still kept his fiddle hung at the head of his bed. And when he took on well at 85, the minute he departed, the fiddle went, there was one shot on the wall, and she went away in 100 minutes. She was enchanted, you know, no other body could get her. So that finished the fiddler.
Very sort of that.